Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to some more Dominions 5 Multiplayer Showdown, Episode 9, Turn 9 for the series here. And I'm joined again by Chris. We've got a lot of things to go over real quick in the messages screen. So we're going to scan through these really quickly. I'll start with a message from Stis here, which is Nucrium. So he says, we wish this message could have been brought to you on better terms, but we feel we must warn the world of a potential new threat. Vile birds have been seen circling our lands, defiling our statues, squawking insults at even the smallest, most innocent hatchlings. Our expert scouts follow them back to their homeland, a region known as Pangea, which is Dwarf Comic. Their continuous scout the area will inform of any further disturbances. So I think he's just maybe caught some of Dwarf Comic's scouts floating around.
Yeah.
Then he messaged us. He said, well met, Hydras of the South. Your recent expansion into Bleak Grove has given us pause. Can we trust your expansion ends there? We had planned on using that force as a new breeding ground, but can perhaps work on another solution to the ever-expanding lizard population. Unless you would consider payment for the land, our spies are quite knowledgeable and would be willing to share information in exchange. Another solution to the ever-expanding lizard population. And mind you, we're kind of both playing like serpent kind of nations, so
yeah.
But I think Nook and Dwarf Comic are going to go to war at some point here. That's kind of my take on it.
It sounds like that, yes.
And then we've got Utgard, so we will stand with any opposing force to Mictlan, but we cannot start the hostilities. After a clash between our forces, our giants have found themselves outperformed. Mictlan's capital is located west of us, Province 87. So I have to take a look and see where they are. But there is a need to take action soon. So Utgard here, a little bit worried about Mictlan. They must have bumped armies at some point, and Utgard got their faces smashed in.
Yeah.
So that's not good. There is a need to take action soon, so I'm worried that
Utgard is worried that Midland will try to rush him, I think.
Yeah, I think he is too. That might be too. He might just be playing us to try to get us to band up against.
Yeah, it could be.
Who's playing Mictlan? It's Lucid, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so he's probably just trying to get us to band up against Lucid. Because he's worried that Lucid's going to knock him right out of the game.
Yeah, I think so.
All right, we'll go watch this battle. Just one Hydra and some Cataphracts. Ooh, that's a big.
That's quite a lot of heavy.
Not too much heavy cav. I hope they don't pass. That's my concern. And they're going to pass. The Cataphract should.
So they'll catch them, yes.
And they are blessed. There it is.
Yeah, they can beat them.
Did the Hydra get blessed? Yes.
It's a bit alone up there, so hopefully. It might actually just take out the commanders, because it seems like the other ones are going to pass through. That would be okay.
Yep, it's going right for the commanders, so we might actually just rout the army anyways. Hopefully sooner rather than
later. We might not even have to fight these guys.
Oh, yeah, there we go.
One more commander and they are, yeah, we got them.
There they go.
Now they're out.
Nice. So we didn't lose anything, and like you said, we didn't even really have to fight.
Yeah. That was not what I expected to happen, but it was good anyway.
Yeah, the Hydra beelining it to the commanders worked out nicely just in this particular scenario, mainly because the rest of the army kind of went around. It's good that we had the Cataphracts there. We probably would have been in trouble. And that's why we'll want to have a couple more of them eventually guarding our other commanders with Hydras. They make a really nice buffer. Young men have been disappearing, leaving their beds empty the night of the full moon. Oh man, more unrest. One of the local nobles is afraid of uprising, so we got some defense.
We need to send a force to patrol that forest province, because it's there's something.
Oh, how about this?
That needs to be found there.
31 unrest, 3 misfortune, 1 unit has been cursed.
That's probably just a random event that doesn't mean anything. But there has been a lot of events in memory of druids, so there is something there we need to take care of, I think.
I think so too. Yeah, we've had a lot of stuff there.
If you select the province and hit I on the keyboard, you will get information on. You can see.
Children have been disappearing. Travelers have been disappearing. Grisly heap also, of carcasses was found.
It says in the first event, at least a handful of men will be needed to effectively search the area. So that means that probably means that if you set a group to patrol there, they'll find and stop whatever it is.
Oh, and leaving their beds empty at the night of the full moon. It's werewolves.
Yeah. Probably is.
Huh. All right. Well. We could send this army down to patrol, I guess.
I don't think it's important enough to that we need to do anything right now, because we probably need that commander.
This one here?
Yeah.
We've got this commander as well. He's got a head to memory of druids anyways.
Yeah, that's right.
So
he has to.
So he's got to go that way. So we might as well send him.
But I don't think he has enough patrol strength to find the problem. But of course, if the werewolves attack, and they might attack at some point, then he'll be there to stop them.
Yeah.
If they attack next turn.
There is the army there.
Yeah.
Shamblers.
So he also has champions.
I wonder if he's recruiting them. So he's gonna go for these.
He might, yes. That's not so good if he does that.
No, I think we might be going to war with him.
We'll see.
I think we'll be going to war with him, because I definitely don't want to lose these. All right, we got a lot of units here. Do we want to just go right for Wolf's March with them all?
No, I think the plan was to send only
one of them.
Yes, and three hydras, and then send the cataphract and one hydra down to the swamp, and then meet up with the forces from the capital to take a ruin of Bow. Boat murders next turn.
Okay, yeah, because we got some hydras here.
Yeah.
Just one, we're taking just one hydra and a cataphract with us?
Yes.
So you want to do this?
Yeah, and then put one hydra up in this army. So there's three up there, yeah.
Okay.
Exactly.
And we're going to send him down to the swamp. Just him.
Yes.
And then here we're going to attack, which we shouldn't have an issue. 30, mainly heavy infantry, heavy cav. With three hydras, that shouldn't be a problem. Should we move these hydras around?
Yeah, I think...
Actually, they're in a pretty good...
I was thinking if we put him... the commander, not all the way back, but mostly all the way back, like there, yeah. And then put one hydra in front of him. Yes, and then the two other hydras on the flanks, all the way back. All the way back to the back line, so they're further back than he is.
Oh, okay.
Because if it is as I think that the independents are mostly set to attack rearmost, then they will actually go for the hydras instead of the commander. So that's my hope.
Okay, we'll see.
And no matter what they do, they're going to run into the hydras.
Yeah. Either way, even if they flank.
Yeah.
Even if they flank, they're gonna hit a big pile of hydra, so not too worried.
He needs to bless four times this because he needs to place all the hiders one by one.
So four times.
And himself also, so.
So he's just doing blessings all the way down the line.
Yeah, he can't do anything else anyway, so it really doesn't matter. But
yeah, good point. I just said it anyways, though.
On this, there's undead, and I don't think there's any undead in the province. So.
Okay. And for this army, what do we want to do with these guys? Should we move them back to the capital?
I think so.
And get them. we'll assign some new units to them. They could use.
Yeah, or make him the prophet next turn.
Oh, yes, we'll make him the prophet. He's got to be in the capital for that, correct?
No, he could do it now, but...
Oh.
Yeah.
Should we make him the prophet?
Yeah, maybe not. It's not a really serious affliction, but...
We could just make another one, I guess.
Yeah. But we don't have to decide that right now. But we need to move the forces out into the...
Swamp.
Yeah.
We're taking this guy, right?
Yes.
So, Hydras and Cataphracts.
I think take all the forces, also the...
These guys?
Yes.
I was going to leave them for this army.
Yeah, but what would you do with them? That we don't have any province left to take, really.
Yeah, that's a good point. Unless we wanted to try to take Providence.
Yeah. I don't think they're enough for that.
I don't anyway. Think so either.
I was actually thinking we might go for the throne soon.
This one?
Yes. Because it's only Springhawks and... And in Kido soldiers, light infantry. The only thing that have slashing weapons are the heavy infantry. So the Hydras will be very good against them, and we'll be up to 7 or 8 Hydras soon. So, and a fair number of Cataphracts.
All right.
So that should actually be possible.
All right, we'll start moving people around to do that then. So I agree, we'll get these guys moved with him.
Set them to guard commander.
Oh, I can't because I set these guys. You don't want the Cataphracts guarding?
Yeah. No. They need to be attacking.
You want them to just attack the closest enemy?
Yeah, but it doesn't matter. We have to move things around next turn anyway, so... I don't think anything would attack this swamp.
Yeah, good point.
So
good point. I'll go ahead and just set this so I've got it though.
But yeah, it's a good idea to bless just in case.
Wait, no. There.
And we probably should move the servant priest into the swamp too, so he can search for sites there.
bring him with us, the servant priest. Okay.
Yeah.
Because he's got a better blessing, anyways, doesn't he?
He does.
There's nothing here we really want. We just want the.
You can use the Sermon of Poet cards.
Oh, which one of these do we want him doing?
The other ones are not really any good right now.
Yeah, it's just the Divine Blessing we want.
Yeah. But that would require... a communion. And a Servant Priest with Astral magic.
I guess we can have him do a Sermon of Courage.
Yeah.
That's really it.
And blessing, yeah.
and then just cast spells.
Doesn't matter, you're not really attacking anything, so...
Yeah. So he's moving, they're all moving, these guys are just doing research, research, sap to do still. Alright, let's recruit some units. We got a lot of gold.
Whoa, yes.
Oh, actually, real quick though, what did we take? We took right here, this one.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so, wow, yeah.
I actually think we need to move one of the acolytes to the Amazon province so we can get started on the temple and a lab there too.
To this prob. Oh, so we can get a temple going.
Yeah.
Okay. We can do that, and then let's go ahead and recruit an acolyte to replace him.
No, a serpent priest.
Okay, so we're going to go just serpent priest now?
Yeah.
And use their research?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's better.
And we could get one of these for being our prophet. So we had a
serpent priest for our prophet?
No, a tribune.
A tribune? Yeah, we'll get one for our prophet. Yeah. And then we want a hydra.
Yeah, and as many cataphracts as we can make. Yeah.
And then we'll just get a few of these with what's left. That's all our resources.
That's not really,
bummer. All right, well, that's it then. That's what we're getting.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Yeah, that's really good.
We could start.
Oh, we did end up getting the ring of underwater breathing.
Yeah, but we don't really need it this turn.
Yeah, we just wanted to make it so we'd have it. We were going to give it to... Who are we going to give it to?
The guy we're moving in, actually. This guy. He will then drop off his shoulders, take the ring and go up to... So we need to produce some...
the Bleak Grove.
Some of the shrampers up there.
Shrampers. Yeah, we're going to want to start getting them built. How many do we want?
Oh, we need at least 15, I would say, for taking the water province, I think.
Do we want to take a... cataphract off to get some more?
No, we can get more. There's not enough recruiting points for more than the three.
Oh, so then we'll just... Yeah, you're right. That's it. We're out of recruitment points. So this is fine then. We'll just let this sit.
Yeah. Just set it to repeat.
Yeah. Well, by the time that we get this guy here, give him the ring of underwater breathing and send him up there, there should be about 15 of them ready to go.
Yeah.
So, all right, let's move our scout. Where is our scout? Okay, so we managed to move him here. Province 87. I wanted to see where.
Yeah.
But I don't think I'm gonna.
I think you can.
Can you search? Oh.
Yeah, I can't remember how.
I don't either. I guess it doesn't. Oh, right there.
Yeah.
Okay, he's nice, okay. Nice and far away.
Yeah.
He's got almond.
Yeah,
he's far away. So.
Yeah, we knew he couldn't be close because we already knew the three closest.
Yeah, so this works out.
But he's not the one that's on the other side of the water. Then we know there's one. There's one somewhere around. No, the other side of the big.
Somewhere right here.
Part of water. No.
Right here.
Over there, I think. Yeah, I actually feared he was there because then he would probably go straight into the big sea or lake there.
Yeah.
But if he's not there, there's a good chance we can actually take all the water.
Good. We definitely need to. We should be able to. I'm hoping they won't do it.
Yeah,
if
he does.
Falconeers go into water?
No.
Okay, so
only the
shamblers. Okay. Yeah.
I don't think he has enough shamblers to go to it yet, but I wonder where he got them from. If they're from,
could it be mercenaries?
It could be. Actually, I'm remembering mercenaries. We probably should check out what mercenaries there is, because we could easily afford some if they're good. Oh, somebody has
Pangea.
It's actually it's nuclear, isn't it? Yes.
All right.
I don't think they're mercenaries, but he has mercenaries, but not anyone we want.
No.
I was just wondering if there was any that could go into water, because then we wanted them.
All right, so we'll take Wolf's March. We're heading to Ruin of Boat Murder. We're going to try to go for the throne, and our commander here will get the Ring of Underwater Breathing, and he'll head towards Bleak Grove, hopefully by the time he gets up there, we'll have a group of shamblers. And we can start, we'll probably take these three first, right?
Yeah, I think we should take Nightspring Sea first, because it's close, and the mermen we can make there, they can go on land, so we can make more of them, and more shamblers, and then we can join them with the shamblers.
Can the mermen go on land?
Yes.
Oh.
They can.
For some reason, I thought they couldn't.
It's only the Tritons that can't go on land.
Okay. So we can make mermen and cross here and go into Dread Squad Wash.
And then we may soon have the manuals of water breathing, so we can send Hydras into the water too.
Yeah, which would be perfect. And I'm thinking that that'll work out great if we end up with this throne and this throne. Boy, the Golden Basket, too, is right outside Goodlands.
Yeah.
And it's easy.
We also need to be careful not to take too many thrones too early, because if the other players notice that, they are going to attack us.
I know. Yeah, we got to be careful. We got to kind of be sneaky about it.
Yeah, we need to be able. And we have one problem. We only have the prophet that can claim thrones. We cannot claim more than one throne at the time. So
yeah,
we may want to wait until our guard is out, or we could go for being able to summon bishop fish. They're called which has a Holy Tree and can claim thrones.
Okay. Where can
the
we
only
get
problem
them?
That is that they're conjuration 6, so and it's not really the way we want to go.
Oh, yeah.
Other things, so yeah, but we don't need to decide that now.
Nope, that'll be for later on once we.
Yeah.
I mean, we know we're gonna have this one regardless. We'll have to build a fort here and probably hold this. I think this might be at least a 2-point throne, if not three.
Definitely at least a 2-point throne, yeah. I think if it is the 3-point throne, we should probably not claim it, because the other people might not know it's the high-level throne, because they may not have seen it yet when we take it. And as soon as we has taken it and not claimed it, they cannot know what throne it is. So only we would know it.
So you're thinking just like wait outside
and
of
then,
it?
And then, no, we take the throne and build a fort there, but we don't claim the throne.
Oh, yes.
And then when we have enough of other thrones, we can claim it and then win the game. That's the idea.
Yeah, we'll know what throne it is, right? Once we claim it?
Yeah.
Or once we're on it?
Yes.
Yeah, so we can actually get on there, we'll decide whether or not we want to actually claim it. If we decide not to claim it, we'll build a fort and hold it. We'll try to snipe a few other thrones, and then we'll just we'll get like maybe some small thrones and claim them.
Yes.
And then people won't know this is a three-pointer. We could claim it and like just rip the game out from underneath everybody. That'd be hilarious.
It would.
Oh. Yeah, these are all things, future things, but stuff to start kind of thinking about.
Yeah.
Because we're getting pretty close to getting towards that throne anyways.
But if they're one of the good two-point zones, we probably want to claim it because it's would make us stronger, but yeah, we'll see.
Yeah. All right, so I think that's it. I don't think there's anything else. Oh, where do we want to move our scout?
Yeah.
Let's see. You want to try to see who's over here?
Yeah, I think that's a good idea.
So we're heading that way. We have one more scout now too.
That's right. Let's move him towards Alm.
Towards Alm. You want to go in the golden basket or go right towards his?
Right towards his province. Okay. So we can see how much he expanded, how strong he seems to be.
Yeah, because I think we might brush shoulders with him.
I'm a bit surprised he haven't taken that.
Yeah, I'm starting to think we should just go take it. Take some Hydra. We could take that so easy with Hydras.
Yeah.
You know,
fairly easy. Yeah. It's actually pretty well defended, but it's that many Hydra we have now, it's no problem at all.
Yeah, I feel like we could just go there with three Hydras and take the whole thing.
Yeah.
It'd be high income too. We should consider it. Alm would be super upset, but if we're more powerful than him, what's he going to do about it? We already know Dwarf Comic and Alm are not getting along, so...
Yeah, let's see when we get a scout in. He might be quite strong, just to expand it in other direction.
Yeah, exactly. So once we get a scout, we can make a decision. But all right, I think that's it then, right?
And VS... I'm actually thinking we are still producing more scouts in
we've got more in good lands right now coming. We got on repair.
Yeah, that I think that's okay. I think there's another province we can make scouts in. I think it's Bishop's Droop, isn't it?
Yes. Can we in Cerulean Views? Yes.
So we have lots of scout provinces, but we are kind of out of money, and I don't want to drop anything we are producing. So I don't think we.
Yeah, well, if we think we need it, we'll do it next time. We'll think it over.
Yeah.
Collingwood Reach too.
If we have a gold lift after producing the important stuff, we'll just make some extra scouts next time.
Yeah, exactly. I agree. So, all right. Well, I guess that's it with everything. So with that being said, we want to thank you all for joining us. We hope that you've enjoyed it, and we look forward to seeing you next time.